Hello viewers, today we have with us a very young IAS officer, Dr. Devansh Yadav, who is the Deputy Commissioner of Changlang District. So welcome to Arunachal Mirror, sir. So sir, right
Thank
now,
you.
The total number of COVID cases has risen in Arunachal Pradesh, and the highest number is in Changlang District. There is 55 positive cases. So sir, can you update us regarding the present situation in the district?
So yesterday we had 13 more positive cases, and before that the figure for previous day was 42.
Yes.
And 6 more positive cases came late at night. So the total tally now stands at 55. As of now, the quarantine center facility and COVID care center facility is adequate. Just 2 days back, we have received a fresh team of doctors and also lab technicians. From our end, also at the district level, we have hired more lab technicians to take up with the more testing that will be required for the people who are testing positive. So as of now, the situation is very much in control, and it is evolving, and with the situation, we are preparing us.
Okay, sir. Are those all the 55 patients in Changlang itself, or some are in PTC Bandaduwa?
All 55 are in Changlang itself.
Okay, sir. So, can you also update on the COVID care center and the quarantine facility in the district?
So, right now we have more than 2300 beds available in quarantine centers.
Yes.
However, the issue has come up that in some of the areas there are beds which are not being vacated because some high-risk contacts have come. For example, if in a quarantine center someone is tested positive, then automatically the quarantine center is sealed.
Yes.
And everyone who is sitting with that person becomes a high-risk contact.
Okay.
So in those areas, we have opened up new quarantine centers. And we are also now planning to expand more quarantine centers. As of now, we have adequate capacity to absorb around 500 to 600 people in the district if they come on any short notice.
Okay.
Regarding COVID care center, when this whole COVID crisis started, we had around 80 beds spread across various community health centers.
Okay.
On the day of 1st June, when the first 16 was tested positive suddenly.
Yes.
And those things were located in Kotusa subdivision. So at that time, we had to expand the COVID care center capacity. So now we have a COVID care center capacity of over 240. And since, like I told you, we have a fresh team of doctors which has joined us recently, and also, like most importantly, lab technicians. So we are trying to utilize them in the most judicious manner.
Okay, sir. Is there any new SOP from the administration?
As of yet, we are not changing any of our SOPs. There is a new SOP which has come up, but at the district level, we are still analyzing it because all the previous cases which have come up, we are taking them as per the SOP which has been provided to us.
Okay.
And for anyone who is testing positive, we are keeping them in COVID care center. On day 14, we are testing them, and after 24 hours, again we are testing them.
Okay.
So only after 2 negative cases will we release them. Now, as you know, on 1st of June, first COVID case was detected in Changlang.
Yes.
So if you take from 1st, now in within next 1 to 2 days, we'll be doing the repeat test of these people.
Okay.
And that will be the chance when we will be able, if God help us, then at that time we will be having some negative results because all the cases are asymptomatic. So then we will be able to reduce our load in COVID care centers.
Okay, sir. We have also seen some reports on the locals opposing to put a halt on returnees to a certain part of the Changlang.
So as such, we have no dedicated train coming to Arunachal.
Okay.
Whatever group of returnees are coming, they are coming for trains which are coming either to Assam or to other northeastern states, and they are coming in that. Some are coming through flights as well. From our level, it is we are trying to persuade the local people that there are two issues. First issue is that you talk to the parents of people who are there in Delhi, in Bangalore, Chennai. You ask them the address. In those addresses, we will provide all the basic necessities. Even last week, we provided some basic emergency items to people in Noida, and we asked them not to come, and they obliged.
Okay.
So we are trying to minimize the intake, and even if they want to come, we are saying that okay, you come, but you plan your journey in a manner that we are able to take in stepwise, rather than all of you coming in once.
Okay.
Another issue was coming that some people were saying that there are people coming from other states, and since there are many people, so they are not being identified. Now, as of now, at our check gates, magistrates are deployed. All the entries are happening at the check gates. All the documents which they are submitting, they are kept with the magistrates. They have to fill up the forms. There are no people coming from outside.
Okay.
But even then, there were some local issues. So what we did is we brought community leaders together. We brought student leaders together. Our ADCs, especially ADC Bodrumsa and ADC Miao, they conducted local meetings. In past 2 to 3 days only, they have completed those round of meetings.
Okay.
They are issuing ID cards to these volunteers who will be doing local inquiry along with magistrates and police. And they will be clearing their apprehensions if someone has come out from other states.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. So is there any kind of message you want to convey through this conference? Because people are a little bit apprehensive right now that the number of cases, the manner in which it's rising in Changlang.
Even though the number of cases is at least when you sit in Itanagar, it might look 55 and it is a crisis and all, but it is not like that.
Okay.
And we are very much in control. Our COVID care center capacities are increasing on a weekly basis. And like I told you, the people who tested positive on 1st of June, they will be retested in 1 to 2 days. So we are expecting they will test negative. Further decrease in load will be there. Also, we are sending all our test samples to Delhi and Dibrugarh combined. So results are coming faster now.
Okay.
So there is nothing to worry. We are in control. Even if someone is testing symptomatic, we are having oxygen cylinders in sufficient numbers. And we are also having non-rebreather and normal masks so that the basic symptoms can be taken care of in the COVID care center itself.
Okay. Sir, what about other medical related issues? Is there any hospitals over there, like the people can go and for some daily routine checkups?
Yeah. So, for example, if a community health center is being made into a COVID care center,
yes,
then automatically the PHC or CHC nearby to it becomes the normal OPD or normal delivery center.
Okay.
This has happened in Bodrumsa. This has happened in Taiyun. Where different facilities not located in the same compound,
okay,
they take care of normal duties. And the doctors of COVID duties are kept separate from doctors of other duties. So that patients don't have any apprehension. Even today we had this stock taking of vaccination.
Okay.
Now vaccination and other activities can suffer greatly if all the health man for workforce is kept for COVID duty. So now we are trying to ensure that basic medical facilities, they don't get suffered. Because as of now, all our patients are asymptomatic. Regarding medical attention, we are constantly monitoring them. But there is no active intervention as such which is required right now. So we are asking our medical people to keep their resources accordingly.
Sir, is there any shortage of healthcare workers?
As of now, there is no shortage. Like I told you, just 2 days back, we received a fresh team of doctors. And they have joined as well. And lab technicians have even reported on the field. So there is no shortage of doctors and other medical staff. Regarding nurses also, we are keeping the tab. And we are in touch with the health department. And they have assured us that whenever there is a shortage, just let us know in advance. And even now, we are constantly monitoring. So if there is a shortage, they will come at a very short notice, in 1 or 2 days.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Sir, you are giving a great service to the state. We are really obliged for it. So we will keep in contact
Thank you.
In days to come.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for time, sir.
Thank you.